Welcome to this week's episode of the DevOps Lab, where we're covering off episode 3 in our identity series for developers. So tune in as we automate with Azure Automation and Microsoft Graph. Welcome back to the DevOps Lab, and we're here with episode 3 with Christos. Welcome back again.
Nice to be here.
Good to have you. So today we're going to talk about Azure AD automation and Microsoft Graph.
Yes, absolutely.
What is Microsoft Graph?
Microsoft Graph is a unified API that allows you to access a lot of Azure and Azure Active Directory resources without having to worry too much about the API consistency.
Okay.
So we took all the services, OneDrive, SharePoint, Dynamics, Azure Active Directory, and we brought them under one umbrella. Mm-hmm. There's obviously different endpoints, but you have one consistent way of authenticating and accessing these resources. And that allows you to do a lot of magic things like bulk inserting users to Azure Active Directory or automating things as we're going to see soon.
Okay. I love automation.
Yes.
So I'm excited to see this.
Yes.
So why don't you take it away? You should probably tell people why we should automate this first. I mean, I believe in automating all the things.
All the things.
So why do we need to automate it?
We do know that most of the failures in IT happen due to human errors somewhere in the process, whether it's creating code that doesn't run as it should be or deploying something with the wrong credentials or messing something up. So we want to eliminate the human element as much as we can. And sometimes automation helps with scaling up and scaling out. Mm-hmm. So with regards to DevOps and identity, there are a lot of things that we can do to make developers' lives easier. And IT people can look at what they need to do to automate things so developers can just up and running without having to work through the process. Because we do know people screw up quite a bit when they set up Azure Active Directory for authentication.
Yeah, and it's also things like when someone goes on leave, on vacation or on holiday, like, and they've had a manual process set up, like we need to mitigate that and automate that. So go ahead and take it away and show us MS Graph.
Perfect, so the easiest way to get started with Graph is to use the Graph Explorer. There's a play area where you can go and test things out, but it's super powerful because it gives you a lot of things. You can come to the Graph Explorer, ak.ms/GE. You can use it without an authenticated user. You don't have to have a signed in user. You still get dummy data to play with. But if you want to actually start doing queries against your own data, then it's nice because you can easily sign in. And here, if I run this query, it just returns the data for my object, for myself. On the left-hand side, there's a lot of prefabricated queries to allow you to do certain things. But since we're talking about applications, Azure Active Directory application registrations, I'm going to use that as an example. So there's an applications tab over here. As you can see, I can list all my applications. It already changed the query up here in the Query Explorer. And I run that, and it brings back all the app registrations I have. And we can even filter things out if we want to, like this. And there you go. Now, there are two things that are super useful here. One is that you're going to get an access token, dump it into your code, and start playing around without having to go through the authentication process first. You can also find what kind of permissions you need to use for every API endpoint, because they're always different. And then the biggest key, and the one that I love, is that you get code snippets. So if your boss says, I know you can't see it because it's too far at the bottom, but let's say your boss says, hey, I want you to go and build something with Graph, and it needs to pull emails, right? Now, you can spend a lot of time looking at the documentation, or you can come in the Graph Explorer, run the query, and then grab the code. It's not cheating. Take the rest of the day off, and you're done. Easy peasy, don't tell your boss.
It's not cheating. You're just leveraging the advantage of the code to automate it for you.
Exactly.
Absolutely.
But I want to take it a step further. So what I said, how can we use this tool to automate Azure Active Directory app registrations?
Okay.
This is the key. Because this, again, I've dealt with that many, many times. A lot of developers had issues with this. And what I want to do now is I want to show you a little bit of code that we can use to do all that. In fact, I wrote it as a notebook. So Python notebooks are very well known because they can automate things. And they also come with a little bit of text that can explain what things happen. And now we have a .NET version for that.
Awesome.
We also have JavaScript and PowerShell. So whatever language you want to double with, you can do this. And in this example, we're going to set up an API with an SPA. So an API app registration allows you to call an API, authenticate it. And then a single page app can be Vue, it can be Angular, it can be React. And we'll show you what settings you need to get out of Azure Active Directory. It will set everything up for you, cool. and you're able to run. So let's run through the example. First, we can pull some dependencies down. Notebooks allow you to install dependencies, so NuGet packages for .NET. Yep. That installed, took a couple of seconds. Now we create a client or a credential for our Graph client. And that runs successfully, as you can see down here. And now we're ready to create an app registration. The credential can be lots of different things. I'm using an interactive one just to show you how the authentication works. But it can be a service principal. It can be other credentials. So now it should prompt me for an authentication. And I'm going to use the right account. And that should have already completed the run, actually. So if we go down here, we should see that it already generated the client ID that we need okay. for our API, the domain, and the tenant ID. This is the information we need for a .NET API. Mm-hmm. And then we need to create a service principal so we can actually interact with it in our tenant. That's all done again. And finally, we are creating the app registration for our SPA. And because we have already authenticated, it has a token. It went and created that, and it turned back the client ID. SPAs only have client IDs. And that's it. Now, if I go back to my Azure Active Directory tenant, we should see the app registration that has just been created. We got my CM demo API and the client one, which we created. So there you go. I didn't have to do anything to interact with Azure Active Directory. I run it through the notebook. Now, you can run notebooks as part of your CI/CD pipeline. Mm-hmm. Not .NET yet. I'm afraid this is coming. But in the meantime, you can do the exact same thing with a Python notebook.
Can you do it in PowerShell?
You can do it in PowerShell. Mm-hmm. That's true.
Awesome. There cool. So now you can take the rest of the day off.
Yes. Awesome. Thank you.
Cool. Just to tell your boss. Awesome, Christos. Thank you for showing how to automate all of that from beginning to end. It makes things a lot easier. It pops out all the things we need to connect to those APIs. Seems pretty easy. What's the catch?
There's no catch. Just download the codes. It's on GitHub, so you can go and find it there. We'll have the links below, and you can start using it today.
Cool. So for everyone out there, check out the show notes. We'll have the link to the GitHub repo so you can get started and do exactly what Christos did. Probably don't take the rest of the day off. But thank you, everyone, for joining today. And join us on our next episode when we cover off some more identity stuff for developers.